Welcome to the session of UX goal, metrics and target. In this session, we are going to cover various parameters such as UX goal, UX target table, UX measures, UX metric, baseline level and target level. And we will see all these parameters with an example of ticket kiosk system. Let us start with the first parameter, that is UX goal. UX goal are the objectives which are set for an interaction design to attain the user experience. UX goals reflect the real use of a product and identify what is important to organization, customer and its users. UX goal comes from the concerns or major barriers which we have seen in various models such as flow model, social model, etc. The examples of a UX goal are as follows. First, high customer satisfaction. Second, ease of use. Third, avoiding errors for users, and fourth, fast learning, etc. Let us see the next parameter, that is UX target table. UX target table is the table which is used to measure usability using various parameters. Each row in this table is called as the UX target. The first three parameters are work role, which consists of user class, UX goal, and UX measure. All these three parameters go hand in hand, as the UX measure is aimed at supporting the UX goal and is specified with respect to work role and user class. Next, we come to UX measure. Now, when I say the term UX measure, it determines that to achieve a goal, what kind of UX characteristics are we going to consider to measure? So, depending on that, we have objective UX measure and we have subjective UX measure. Now, when I say objective UX measure, we measure the initial performance, we measure the long-term performance, we measure the learnability, we measure the retainability, and we measure the advanced feature usage. Now, when I say objective measures, it is directly measured by the evaluators. Now, when I say subjective measures, it is based on opinion. Hence, when I use objective measures, I give some task to the user to perform, and then I measure the value. Whereas when I say subjective measure, I will give some kind of questionnaires, and depending on that, what kind of ratings are we getting? Depending on that, the following measures will be taken. Here is the example. Now, in this example, there is a ticket buyer as the work role. Now, the ticket buyer is a new user and he is trying to use the ticket kiosk system. Now, for that, the UX goal which is set up is ease of use for new user. Now, for achieving this goal, the measure what we are going to see is the initial performance of the user. Now, second goal is initial customer satisfaction. And for that, we are going to measure by the first impression. Now, in this case, when I say initial user performance, it is objective measure. And when I say first impression, it is subjective measure. So, initial performance is objective. Hence, we are going to use some kind of task for measuring it. When I say first impression, it is subjective, hence we are going to use some kind of questionnaires for measuring it. Now, when I say over here, the goal refers to the ability of a typical occasional user to do at least the basic task on the first try without using some kind of training or any kind of manual. Next, we come to measuring instrument. Now, when I say measuring instrument, it is a method for providing values for a particular UX measure. Now, when I say I'm considering UX measure as objective UX measure, I'm going to use some kind of my benchmark task. Like for example, error rate measure, time on task measure, etc. Now, when I say subjective measure, where I'm using UX measure as subjective, the measuring instrument will be some kind of questionnaires, and depending on the questionnaires, what kind of average rating the user will get on that. So here, when I go for the example, my UX goal, as we've discussed before, is ease of use for new user. Now, UX measure is the initial performance. Now, since this is objective, we are giving some kind of task to the user. The task is buy special event ticket. The special event could be maybe for football, maybe for live concert, etc. Your BT1 stands for benchmark task 1. Now, when I say second task. Now, second task also UX measure is initial performance. Now, here we're giving again a task. The reason for giving a task is that this is the objective measure of the UX measure. The second task is buy movie ticket. Now, when I say first impression is the subjective UX measure. For that is the reason why we have considered question as the parameter for measuring instrument. Next we come to UX metric. UX metric is what kind of value we need to be obtained for UX measure. Now this also depends on the objective and subjective values. Now when I come to the table, in this table we have seen that initial performance, to measure initial performance we have used special event ticket. Now for special event ticket, UX metric set is the average time taken. Like for example, if I am buying special event ticket, how much time am I taking up to complete the task from the start. Now second, if I see over here, second is BT2, that is benchmark task 2 is to buy movie tickets. Now when I am buying movie ticket, here I am going to measure how many errors I am going to make while buying a ticket. Now the next one is questionnaires. Now for questionnaires, we are just going to see what is the average rating we are getting to perform the particular task. Now here if I see, when I consider UX metrics, goals and target, it is just not based on one phase of UX life cycle. It comes up from the start, from analysis phase to the evaluation phase. That means UX goal and metric should be set from analysis to evaluation phase. Next we come to baseline. Now when I say baseline is the benchmark level of UX metric, where a value of performance indicator is set before the implementation of the activity. It is often the level measured for the current version of the system. Now when I say target is a specific value or a specific result which needs to be achieved within a given time frame. So when I say over here, we have seen the work role, we have seen the goal, we have seen the initial measure, we have seen what measuring instrument we have used, we have seen the metric. Now when I come to baseline, now baseline to perform the special event task. Now this special event task which is there for the MUD system, so it is 3 minutes. Here the number of errors which the user should make is less than 1, that means no error should be made. And the rating for the questionnaire is 7.5. When I consider target, now target to complete this task should be 2.5. That means user should take 2.5 minutes to complete the task. The number of errors here is less than 1. Then the average rating is 8/10, and then again the number of errors for a new task is less than 1. Hence we have seen the meaning of UX goal, measure, measuring instrument, metric, baseline level, target. Thank you.